Overnight, President Trump suffering a personal political defeat and touting a victory for the country, the FDA's decision to authorize a coronavirus vaccine.
This is one of the greatest scientific accomplishments in history. It will save millions of lives and soon end the pandemic once and for all.
Just hours earlier, the president taking aim at the FDA, calling it a big, old, slow turtle. And the Washington Post reporting Friday afternoon that Chief of Staff Mark Meadows told FDA Chief Dr. Stephen Hahn to clear the vaccine by day's end or submit his resignation. Dr. Hahn telling NBC News in a statement, quote, "This is an untrue representation of the phone call with the chief of staff. The FDA was encouraged to continue working expeditiously." The vaccine victory following the Trump campaign's worst legal loss to date. The Supreme Court slamming the door on the president Friday night, throwing out a case brought by the state of Texas against four battleground states carried by Joe Biden. Texas has not demonstrated a judicially cognizable interest in the manner in which another state conducts its elections, the court wrote. All other pending motions are dismissed as moot.
They should have at least given us a hearing so that we could present our facts.
Republican Senator Ben Sasse praising the court's decision in a statement. Quote, "Every American who cares about the rule of law should take comfort that the Supreme Court, including all three of President Trump's picks, closed the book on the nonsense." The decision capping a day in which President Trump appeared to acknowledge his time in the White House was ending, tweeting that, quote, "the Biden administration will be a scandal-plagued mess for years to come." That administration growing by the day, President-elect Biden announcing five additions to his cabinet Friday and urging Congress to act quickly in passing more coronavirus relief.
It has to get done before they go home. Millions and millions of Americans simply can't wait any longer.
President Trump will enjoy one of the perks of the office today, attending the Army-Navy football game for the last time as commander-in-chief. The Electoral College will ratify Joe Biden's victory on Monday. Kristen?
Garrett Haake reporting from Washington. Garrett, thank you.